Harper Perennial and Harper Audio present Mary Ventura and the Ninth Kingdom, a story by Sylvia Plath, performed by Orlagh Cassidy. Mary Ventura and the Ninth Kingdom was written by Sylvia Plath in 1952, when she was a student at Smith College. The real-life Mary Ventura was one of Plath's high school friends. Plath had written an earlier story about her as part of a creative writing assignment in her second year at Smith. That story, largely autobiographical, concerned a pair of old school friends who meet during the holidays and shared nothing with this one except Ventura's name. In December 1952, she finished writing this story, a vague symbolic tale, in her own description, and submitted it for publication to Mademoiselle magazine, whose writing prize she had recently won. It was rejected. Almost 2 years later, Plath revised the story, changing its title to Marcia Ventura and the Ninth Kingdom, making it less sinister, then curtailing it so significantly as to make it appear half-finished. The version used here is the original rejected work, the richest, and in Faber's view, the best. This is its first publication. All original spellings have been retained. Red neon lights blinked automatically, and a voice grated from the loudspeaker.
Train leaving on track 3. Train leaving for... Train leaving...
I know that must be your train, Mary Ventura's mother said. I'm sure it is, dear. Hurry, do hurry now. Have you your ticket?
Yes, mother, I do. But do I have to go right away? So soon?
You know how trains are,
Mary's father said. He looked anonymous in his gray felt hat, as if he were traveling incognito.
You know how trains are. They don't wait.
Yes, father, I know.
The long black hand of the clock on the wall clipped off another minute. Everywhere there were people running to catch trains. Above them, the vault of the railroad station lifted like the dome of a huge cathedral.
Train leaving on track 3. Train leaving for... Train leaving.
Hurry, dear.
Mrs. Ventura took Mary by the arm and propelled her through the glittering marble halls of the railroad terminal. Mary's father followed with her suitcase. Other people were hurrying to the train gate marked 3. A conductor in a black uniform, his face shaded by the visor of his cap, herded the crowd in through the intricate black grillwork of the iron gate to the platform beyond.
Mother, Mary said, halting, hearing the colossal hissing of the engine on the sunken track. Mother, I can't go today. I simply can't. I'm not ready to take the trip yet.
Nonsense, Mary, her father cut her short, jovially. You're just getting jittery. The trip north won't be an ordeal. You just get on the train and don't worry about another thing until you get to the end of the line. The conductor will tell you where to go then.
Come now, there's a good girl.
Mary's mother tucked a strand of gilt blonde hair up under her black velvet hat.
It will be an easy trip. Everyone has to leave home sometime.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.